Okay, we're gonna make a grid with our paper here. So this is a T-square. I'm going to make sure that I'm above it. So if you're standing at your table, if you're at your table, you should be standing. And I'm going to line up the edge of the paper. First, I want to make sure that this black, see how there's white through here? That's not going to work. This has to be completely flat against the edge of the board. And if you want to have a friend help you hold that, that's fine. Then you're going to get your tape and put your tape on your clothes. That'll help it so that it doesn't stick. You can buy expensive art tape. But all you really need to do is just put it on your clothes. Then I'm going to line it up with the edge of my T-square. Make sure I'm straight. A little stick there. Okay, then I need to measure every inch. I'm going to measure 1 inch. Make sure you're on inches, not centimeters. That'll mess you up. Am I in inches? Oh, it starts from the center. I don't want that one. I want that one.
What?
All right. So I'm not going to measure here and here. I'm just going to measure on one side every inch. Okay. This one's right at 14. Then I'm going to turn it this direction. Actually, I'm going to do it on the left. I'm going to do the bottom. And I'm going to do the left-hand side, but I don't have to do the right-hand side. Okay, mark every inch. Now it's really, really important that you have your measurements correct. If they're off, your entire drawing will be off. Okay, then I'm going to be above my tool, my T-square, so that I can see, make sure there's no negative space. Bad, good. Bad, good. Bad, good. Bad, good. Bad, good. Do not try to just like make a straight edge. That's pointless. The lesson is to learn how to make it with a T-square. Then I'm going to put some pressure on there so it doesn't move. I'm going to lightly make a line. Then I'm going to move it over to the next line. Make sure that my pencil line's right up with it. Make sure my pencil's straight up and down. And it needs to be a wooden pencil. A mechanical pencil, the plastic on it gets stuck. And it makes you mess up. So wooden pencil, and then you're going to just go through the entire thing. Make sure this is flat every single time. And once you get used to a T-square, it's really, really, really fast. I still use a grid method if I'm going to do a large drawing. If I want to enlarge it to a mural, I use a grid drawing. Or if I'm just not quite, if I look at something, I'm like, oh, that just doesn't look right. Then I'll just make a small little grid on it. So be careful when you're at your table. It might be easier to do this on the floor, because when you're at the table, then you can accidentally get this black part on the edge of the table instead of the edge of the board, in which case you will not have a straight line. It'll change every time. So I want to make sure that this is it's flat against there. That's good. That's bad. That's good. That's bad. Good. Bad. Good. Bad. 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 Good. These lines need to be fairly light. You want to be able to see them, but if they're really, really dark, then that means you got to paint a lot more. You're going to have to paint over those lines. All right. Two more lines and my grid will be done. Easy peasy. Ta-da! Yay me, yay me. Grid. Now, the T-square. The T-square, it looks like it would be a fabulous axe. No, that's a think sheet. No, no, Miss Littlefinger, it's not a think sheet. That's a detention. Oh, but wait, is it a laser? Wah, wah, wah. No, no, it is not a laser. But wait, this makes a really great noise. If I go, oh, detention. No, no, detention. All right, be amazing.